Hi, this video is being put together as part of the International Jugglers Association Video Tutorial Contest. I'm Cindy Hamilton of twirlplanet.com, and what I'd like to show you is how to do a thumb toss using a twirling baton. The trick looks like this. I'll also teach you a thumb toss using a staff, as well as a juggling club. There's a variety of tosses and throws that you can do using a baton, but what's really wonderful about a thumb toss is it gives you good control and accuracy of the release. There's three parts to a baton: the metal shaft, the big end, which we call the ball, and the small end, which we call the tip. Hold the baton right in the middle with your hand, in the palm of your hand. We often make reference to thumb to ball, so if you extend your thumb, the starting position for this trick and for a lot of tricks is with the thumb extended directed towards the ball. Drop the baton into a horizontal position so that the ball is on the left side of your body. The palm is down and you're just holding the shaft right in the palm of your hand. Rotate the baton a half revolution in a clockwise direction so that now your palm is up. Your elbow is close to your body, close to the side of your body. Let the baton continue to rotate another quarter of a revolution, another 90 degrees, so that now I'm holding it in the web space right between my thumb and my fingers, and the palm is up. At this point, you're going to extend your thumb forward, clear your fingers out of the way, and the baton will have some momentum and continue to travel in a clockwise direction. I'm going to give it a little push to simulate it, and we're not catching it, just let it go to the floor. It's rolling over the top of my thumb and down to the floor. Again, slowly, rotating the baton in a clockwise direction until the ball is down. The thumb is extended forward into the twirl. It's very important that the baton travels across the top of the thumb. It has some momentum. Let it roll across the thumb and let it drop to the floor. Right, this time I'm going to give the trick a little bit of lift as the baton is traveling across the top of my thumb. Looks like this. Here it is again, nice and slow, rotating around across the top of my thumb, a little bit of lift. It's important to lift the baton straight up. A common error when you're learning this trick is that the baton will fly off in either direction. You're either releasing too soon or too late, so keep practicing until you really get the feeling of a nice straight release right in front of your face that's dropping straight down to your feet. This time, let's try and catch it. What I like to do is catch it in my other hand, which isn't busy. I'm going to place my left elbow close to my side. The elbow is comfortably bent and the left palm is up. This time, as the baton starts to come down, I'm just going to stick my hand into it and see if I can catch it. Here's that slow thumb toss, lift, catching palm up. Don't worry about it if you don't catch it, just give it a try with a few repetitions. Also, don't worry if it's right side up, upside down. At this point, just try to connect with it and make a catch with that left palm. The whole while, be sure that you're using good technique. Be sure that the baton is rolling over the top of the thumb. Your thumb is directed forward, and there's a little bit of lift to give the baton some height. And then finally, let's do a catch in the same hand. This is more typical of a way to catch the baton when you're incorporating this trick into a sequence of movements. So this time when I make the catch, after the baton has been released, I'm going to leave my right hand right in front of me. The fingers will be extended up and the palm away from my body, and I'm going to grab in for the catch. Again, don't worry too much about the amount of revolution. Don't worry about right side up, upside down. Just see if you can connect with that right hand catch. Looks like this. That's a thumb toss. Let's try it with a staff. To do a thumb toss with a staff, the technique is exactly the same. Hold the staff right in the center. You're going to start in a horizontal position. Start to rotate the staff clockwise. until it's in that palm up position. The staff will have some momentum. You're going to extend that thumb forward into the trick, let the staff roll over it, and down it goes. Learn this release with the staff, letting it drop to the floor. This time I'm going to add a little bit of lift with my right hand to create a toss, still letting the staff fall to the ground. Now let's add that left hand catch that we did with the baton. Left palm is going to be up, left elbow tucked in close to my body. It's going to reach in, try to connect with the staff. Don't worry about the amount of revolutions. Let's give that a try. And then finally, we'll try that right hand catch. So after the release, I'm going to orient my hand with the fingers pointed up, palm forward, reach in and try to grab. You can, of course, create throws of different heights in different amounts of revolution. Just experiment with the amount of speed and spin to create the kind of toss that you're looking for. And so finally, let's try a thumb toss using a juggling club. I'm going to hold the club at the very choked up part of the handle where it's close to the body of the club. The orientation is the same as with the baton. If I was to extend the club vertical, my thumb would be extended towards the body of the club. I'm going to drop it down into that horizontal starting position. The body of the club is to the left, handle's to the right. Rotating around to a palm up position, continuing clockwise another 90 degrees until my palm is up. There'll be a bit of momentum. Extend the thumb into the spin of the club and let the handle roll across the top of your thumb. Clubs are short and they tend to be light, so this is hard to do slowly. But be sure that you have the basic technique correct, the same way that you did with the baton, so that the thumb is extended into the spin of the club. This time I'm going to try to add a little bit of lift and let the club fall to the floor. This time, try catching the club in that left hand palm up. And then also try the right-handed catch. Once you've learned the basic technique for a thumb toss and feel comfortable with it, take a look around your house. What else can you do a thumb toss with? I have a couple of ideas. I think it's long enough.